we have the solutions to question two. Okay, you can read it on your own. You have the question paper as well. Okay, so now I will show you the solution. Okay, we have 2a speed. As we have learned in primary school, okay, speed is distance divided by time. So 110 over x. Simple enough. Time increases by 3 seconds, so it becomes x plus 3. So the speed becomes 110 divided by x plus 3. We are then told in part C that the new speed is 2 meters per second slower than its original speed. So we take the original speed minus the new speed, we equate it to 2, because the difference is 2 meters per second. Okay, multiplying both sides of the equation by x, x plus 3. Okay, so I have x plus 3 here. You get this, okay, which I shall not explain. Then you expand, you collect terms on the left-hand side, you divide by 2. Okay, you should be able to prove that x squared plus 3x minus 165 is equals to 0. In 2 part D, we are asked to solve this equation here. There is no way that you can actually factorize this except through the use of the quadratic formula, where you use a quadratic formula to solve for this question. So A is 1, B is 3, C is negative 165. You plug into the equation, negative b plus minus square root of b squared minus 4ac over 2a. You get this x equals to negative 3 plus minus root of 669 over 2. Please take note that this step here is essential. Okay, Cambridge actually expects you to write this step. The square root of 669 is actually worth 1 mark, and negative 3 and 2 is also worth another mark. Okay, in the O-level examinations. Omission of this step will probably lead, in fact, it will lead to loss of marks. So take note that this is an important step. You work it out correct to 3SF, x is 11.4, x is negative 14.4. In 2E, find the speed in kilometers per hour of the cyclist. So speed, distance divided by time. Okay, I do not use negative 14.4 because, you know, there is no way it can be negative, alright? So the speed, right, is not negative. Sorry, not the speed, the time taken, rather. Okay, so now what we do here is this. Speed is distance divided by time. So 11.432. I've actually used the truncated value here. Okay, 11.432 plus 3. Okay, then you just divide it out. You get 7.6219 truncated value. Here, to convert between meter per second to kilometer per hour. If you still have no idea how to do this, please go ask your friends, okay, or ask your teachers how you can convert from meter per second to kilometer per hour. This is something that's already learned in lower secondary. So multiply by 60 divided by 1000, you get 27.4 kilometers per hour. And that concludes question 2.